Hello viewers, welcome to our today's class. Your teacher is Roger Michira. We'll be taking you through history, a form for topic, Organization of African Unity. And the subtopic of discussion is Origin of OAU. Welcome all, and the station you are tuned in is Elimu TV, where we all get to watch and learn. Welcome all, and let us learn. So class, as a topic, Organization of African Unity, these are some of the international organizations that we have been looking at. Now remember, in the past few lessons, we did look at a non-aligned movement, we looked at the League of Nations, we looked at United Nations, we also looked at Commonwealth. Now today, we're getting to look at Organization of African Unity, and we get to look at the origin of OAU. Welcome all, and let us be ready to run. Now class, what do we expect at the end of the lesson? We do expect that we're able to outline the objectives of Organization of African Unity, that is OAU, and also we get to discuss the origin of OAU. Let us begin now. So first, that is the symbol of the OAU, right? Wherever you see that symbol, it symbolizes Organization of African Unity. Right, and as you can see, that circle, in that circle, there is a map, right? And that map clearly shows the African continent. So meaning this was an organization purely for the Africans, right? It was an organization purely for the African states. Now, what does OAU mean? So it simply means Organization of African Unity. Now, can we get to trace the origin of OAU? Now, we get to know that OAU owes its origin to Pan-Africanism, right? And let me take you back that we did look at Pan-Africanism. We said that this is a movement aimed at unifying people of the African origin, people of the African descent, right? Now, OAU can trace its origin to Pan-Africanism, and we have got a number of African Pan-Africanists. For example, Kwame Nkrumah, we had Robert Mugabe, right? We had Nelson Mandela of South Africa. Now, these are people whose unifying factor was the African descent or the African origin. Now, OAU owes its origin to the Pan-Africans movement and was born in the year 1963, May. And in that year, 1963, out of the 32 independent states, right, 30 out of 32 independent African states belong to OAU. Now, where are the offices, or rather, where were the offices of our Organization of African Unity? Then we can get to know that the offices of OAU can be traced in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. And also, class, we get to know that African leaders drew up a charter on 25th May, the same year which it was born, which is 1963, and signed the OAU Charter. Now, that is when they signed the principles and ideals to run the OAU Charter. Then again, another thing that we must have to know is that African states that had not yet gained independence included Kenya, which became a member in 1964. So immediately after Kenya gained independence, that is when we joined OAU. And one thing we have realized from the above origin is that only the independent states joined OAU, right? Then formation of OAU saw the dissolution of all the previous groupings, Brazzaville and Casablanca groups. Now, these were the diaspora groups, the Pan-Africanist movements that were in diaspora, the Brazzaville and Casablanca groups. Now, who were among of the leading statesmen, right? Now, during that conference, right, the May 1963 conference, who were the leading statesmen of Organization of African Union, right, OAU? One is Nelson Mandela, not Nelson Mandela, but Julius Nyerere, right? I always confuse Nyerere and Nelson Mandela because they were leading Pan-Africanists. Now, the first person we have there is Nelson, Julius Nyerere, who was the president, the founding father of Tanzania, Julius Nyerere of Tanzania. Good. Then we also had Kwame Nkrumah, right, the Kwame Nkrumah of Ghana, and also we note that Kwame Nkrumah was one of the leading Pan-Africanists in the Pan-Africanism movement in Africa. And also Kwame Nkrumah was the first president of Ghana. Then also we had Haile Selassie, of Ethiopia, right? He was also a soldier, Haile Selassie of Ethiopia. Now, these were some of the leading statesmen we had that led to the organization, or rather formation of OAU. We had Julius Nyerere of Tanzania, we have Kwame Nkrumah of Ghana, and finally we had Haile Selassie of Ethiopia. Now, class, what were some of the aims of OAU, right? What were some of the aims of OAU? One, it was to promote unity and solidarity of the African states, right? And also defend the sovereignty, territorial integrity, and independence of African states. Now, after Africans had gained independence, right? Now, this is the time they wanted to defend their sovereignty and territorial integrity. And finally, promote international cooperation, having due regard to the Charter of the UN and the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. So there's this international cooperation whereby all these states that were in the OAU were to cooperate both in trade and in everything. Now that we have looked at the origin of OAU, we have looked at the founding fathers of OAU or the leading statesmen of OAU, and we have also looked at the aims of OAU. Now, class, can you get to work out this? Who were the leading pioneers of OAU, right? And for our reference, can you get to Refer Evolving World, History and Government, Book 4 by the Oxford University Press, the 7th edition. And as always, the station you're watching is Elimu TV, your favorite learning station.